first lap was a 1 minute 39.4.
The track is green and the skies are grey here in Azerbaijan. Welcome, though, to the Baku City Circuit, where we're preparing to kick off the weekend's action with a difficult and damp free practice session. And I tell you what, Anthony Davidson, I think we're going to have some fairly anxious drivers in the cars today, as the conditions have not been kind at all for today's session.
Well, sat in the garage, maybe, I suppose.
With conditions as they are, I'd suggest you take a set of full wets. In about 5 minutes, we'll then be working with light rain conditions. Let me know you're okay. right. Engine off, engine off. Okay, that was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. Last lap gives you P3. We're in P3 now.
Welcome to qualifying in the Republic of Azerbaijan. The teams are making their last-minute adjustments before the lights go green, and the fight for pole position can get underway. When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximising top speed.
Fantastic. That was the fastest lap. Our best lap so far is a 1:38.7. track is quiet right now. Let's get out on track while it's clear. bad. Are you all right? Let me know you're all right. That's the fastest lap so far. Well done. Wing is stuck open. We need you to pit in so we can try to repair it. Pit in for repairs. Stuck open. You'll have to come in so we can try and attempt to fix. Pit in for repairs.
It looks like it could be a tense round of the championship here as we prepare to get today's race underway. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4 mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. I'm joined again today by none other than Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, obviously there's a lot of development work that goes on with these cars between the races. You've been both a test driver and a race driver. What differences are there in the way you approach those roles?
Interesting question, Crofty. They're two very different mindsets. I mean, when I tested for BAR, we had full in-season testing where, per driver, you'd cover up to 15,000 kilometres per season. And in that role, it was more about working for the team, trying to help them improve the car and drive as systematically as you could, so that that data could be analysed in the most consistent way. When you're lining up on the grid for a race, however, your frame of mind's all about what you can get out of the situation on that day, and the car's the tool to help you achieve what you want. You still want to focus on setup, of course, but it's more about the here and now, getting yourself as far up the field as possible, and less about development work for the future.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Bottas, Nico Hülkenberg, and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Grosjean, Perez, and Kevin Magnussen, Ocon, Sainz, Fernando Alonso, and Leclerc, Gasly, Stroll, Brendan Hartley, and Sergei Sorokin. Eriksson and Stoffel van Dorn completes the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
You should have some space going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy. Okay, our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. Nice and warm by the end of the lap. Expected for the time being. rest of the grid is forming up, be patient and watch for the lights. That's a good start. Keep it up. Understood, copy that. Turn up the ERS deployment and burn some of this energy. This lap of the race, keep this up. 7.7 seconds. Only one stop to go, one stop left in this strategy. Pit window will open in 14 laps time. the pits. Kimi in the pits. We'll be doing one more stop today. One stop left in our strategy. 13 laps until your pit window is open. Deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. Let me know you're okay. Teammate by 27.9 seconds. We'll be right back. this engine mode much longer, we're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Is 22.0 seconds. is 25.9 seconds. Be careful with the front wing, you've taken some minor damage. Okay, take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. without wing damage, this will be a major performance impact unless you box for a new one. Engine off. Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. Release. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Seconds. is 5.7 seconds. Okay, the gap behind is 5.2 seconds. So far. Great maneuver. You made it look easy. 5.7 seconds. Safety car deployed. The safety car has been deployed. Watch your delta. Make sure you keep it positive as we catch the pack. Okay, some information on signs. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Soft tire. Safety car in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature. And remember, there is no overtaking until the first safety car line. Stay in position until the green flags.
Thank you.
just put in a new fastest lap. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. That's a new fastest lap for the race. Target minus one. Let's turn the engine down, please. is 4.0 seconds. Are you all right? Let me know you're all right. So far. Fuel is a target minus three. We need to save urgently. Mix one, please. Thank you. safety car, virtual safety car. Reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta. Some information on Stroll. They're retiring from the race. Okay, we're low on fuel. Try shifting up the gears a little sooner. This should help us save some fuel. Ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Okay, slow down, slow down. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. Ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Caution, caution. Green flag. Reduce ERS deployment. Teammate by 4.3. 3 seconds. Set of boots. We have started to notice some wear. Should be okay for a bit longer though. Thank you. shift up 3 years earlier, it may help save more fuel. 7 seconds between you and the car ahead. Okay, we're low on fuel. Try shifting up the gears a little sooner. This should help us save some fuel. Brilliant. Nice move. Engine off, engine off. minus 6.4 seconds. Nice work, that brings you up a place. It's a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. save more people. Okay, good work. Great pass. race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
So, another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today.